I don't know how to use my brain, heart, or cock. I am just a bag of worthless meat. Are you ready for this?
Another edition of KFC Radio on the Barstool Sports Network. We got Am I the Asshole today? We got our voicemails. We're back in action. We're going to go through some musical submissions because we got about 10 more of those of people trying to make our new theme song. So we're going to go through the good, the bad, and the ugly from the musically inclined KFC Radio fans.
Not many, I imagine.
Not many, I don't think. Please subscribe to our YouTube, you motherfuckers.
Do that.
While we're talking about our fan base, please fucking subscribe.
Oh, you're looking at the camera.
Yeah.
I don't know right where I had
fucking souls.
Look, is right. That what you always look at when you look over here?
Yeah, the other day I was going to correct you. You thought I was looking at the TV.
I always turn around like, what's on TV? I do it all the time.
Yeah, no, it's just the
every
camera.
Every time I'm like, why is he so enthralled
it's
with
the... It's just the camera.
With Nick's desktop.
Nope, just staring into the souls and the eyes of our listeners
and
viewers.
I never even thought about that. It's and you got, right now.
You got your camera over here.
Yeah, never look at that one. I looked down the barrel.
And what's funny is if you did look at that, I'd be like, what the fuck's wrong? Who's at the door?
I'm going to start.
Yeah.
I'm going to point at it every time. I'm really going to fuck you up. Yeah.
We're idiots.
I am an actual idiot.
Yeah.
like
I know.
Like, dead serious. I
also dead serious.
This is a true story. I had my therapist tell me that I just don't know how to use a brain. She says I am
like
good.
It's a tool.
Yes.
Like it's a bandsaw. Like I don't know how to use that thing.
It's
I don't
like,
know how to use that weed whacker.
Basically, my brain is if you grabbed a hammer and you're trying to use the claw.
Like sideways, yeah.
She's like, it's just like, you don't use it right. You don't know how to use a brain.
What does she say you're supposed to do and what are you doing?
Well, I do like... I just like, we always talk about how I just don't think most of the time. Like, I'm just not, like, nothing's going on in my head. Apparently, because when I do think, I do it about so many different things.
Yeah.
And my brain goes into like hyperdrive. And then the rest of the time, it's like self serving, like being like, we just got to shut down because he gets too animated and uses it too often. It's puppy stuff.
Yeah.
It's puppy stuff.
You like run yourself tired, kind of?
Yeah. And then the brain's like, look, we need to fucking chill. And then
but none of it's
off.
A productive.
None of it whatsoever. Yeah. No.
It's not like you're, like, I feel like guys like Zuckerberg probably like they go into their coding zone and they like use their brain on overdrive and they create Facebook and then they like crash. You know?
Yeah, that's
but
what
you,
I do.
But you're
I
overdrive,
a podcast, Kevin.
Yeah,
I go for 1 hour.
This is your like magnum opus,
or 2 hours, whatever it may be. I go for 2 hours and the brain's
you
like, look, we're done.
You
we're
do
done.
Shut down. Like there are times when we wrap up the podcast. Usually we'll wrap up around like 5, sometimes even like 6, and then like Nick will try to like talk some business and I'm like, John's done.
Yeah.
We'll talk to him.
Yeah, my brain is John, is saving puppy, itself. It's like, if I keep going, I'm going
to
die.
Like, there are times with Keegan where I'm like, you need to take a nap, buddy. And yeah. It's the same thing with you. I know when I need to put John down for a nap.
And she also told me that I, because I'm so fucking pragmatic, that...
Too pragmatic.
Nothing is ever a big deal to me.
Right, yeah.
And she's like, that's why like romantic relationships are so hard for you. And like, maybe not the best idea. And I was like,
Jesus Christ, she's just writing you off from the idea of having any sort of romance?
Bro, she gave me a doctor's note to be a fuckboy.
Imagine that. You don't like, call some girl back and it's like...
Yo, my doctor said it's not a good idea.
Like, you know they're talking about vaccine passports? You got like a fuckboy passport where like the girl can, you know... She could be she calling you up. You could FaceTime her and just be like, look.
Yeah, you're like,
my doctor says I can't be in relationships. That is amazing.
Yeah, I wrote it down in the middle of the Zoom call. I was like, hang on. It's unbelievable.
You got a doctor's note to be a fuckboy. It's the ultimate free pass.
Dude, like, I haven't used it yet. I'm gonna start busting that thing out. Bust it.
But you know what's even better? I remember, this is a long time ago. I had a friend who moved out to L.A., California somewhere, and he was trying to be like a movie, like a script writer, and he actually ended up doing it. But he also, like, he went out there, and he was from Pennsylvania, so he just went out there, and I think it was a whole new world of, like, fucking girls and parties and, you know, just, like, how relationships work and all these things. And I remember him saying, he was like, I'm going to try something out. It was like a Costanza thing. He was like, I'm just going to be honest at all times. And I was like, "You're fucking crazy, man! What
kind of game you running, bro?" Right.
But it would be like kind of ruthless and brutal. But like he would tell girls, and I'm kind of he's probably gonna like see this and be like, "I never did that." But I think part of it would be like, you know, yeah, like listen, I like you, but like I want to fuck other girls too, you know, just like blunt, like yeah, no, like I do enjoy fucking you, but I don't enjoy like anything else, so we're not gonna be a thing. Just like. Cut, you know, no games, no lying, no beating around the bush, even if it was painful. Like, I'm just giving you the brutal truth. And I think if you can't be like, I got a passport to be a fuckboy. But if you did it.
I like how we've conflated mine with honesty. Like,
well, but
I'm exploiting a person I pay.
I think if you couldn't just say, hey, I got a doctor's note to like, you know, hit it and quit it. But if you were to tell some girl, if you were to be like, you know. Like, in speaking to my therapist and really doing, like, some self-reflection, I've just learned about myself that, like, monogamy, you know what I mean? Like, if you just talked it up in these big flowery words I could see girls being like, I really respect the honesty. Like, let's fuck anyway. Because girls are crazy like that.
I think like, mine would be it's honesty, but, like, I'm just,
I'm protecting.
It's not you, it's me. Like,
yeah.
Like my therapist told me that I'm going to drive you nuts.
Right.
Because you're going to care about things and I'm not going to.
You know what? And then they want, you know, then they're like, I can fix you. I can fix you. Yeah. Like that would make them want you even more.
Like, oh, no,
and
I don't even care about that. I don't care about being fixed. I don't want that.
Oh, they would be soaking wet. They'd be like, he's so broken, he doesn't even want to be fixed. I will fuck you every single night. I think that they would then be like, And then you're covered. You could be like, listen, I told you.
My
cards are on the fucking table. I mean, there is, I've said this about with me. It's very nice that all of my darkest, deepest, darkest skeletons are all on the table. There's nothing that when I meet somebody, there's no surprises coming your way. You know fucking everything by then because it's all on the tabloids.
Yeah.
But in this case, you could almost just do that to yourself. You know, you could just do it and just say it, and it's on the table, and it'd be like, I got the doctor note to back it up. I'm not
lying.
I'm not
going to give a shit about anything you ever care about, just so you know.
Right.
And then they will love it. It's like, you'll never guess what happened at work today. Oh, I don't care.
I'll tell you why I'll never guess what happened, because I'm not even going to try.
Yeah.
I don't want to guess because I don't want to know.
Tell me about what fucking Deborah did. Tell me. I'm gonna pretend to give a shit, and then actually, I don't have to pretend to give a shit. Designated Survivor, and they were telling us a proverb, and I was like, oh, that's exactly how I think. And
what is your proverb?
It is. I just googled it to see. It's a Chinese proverb. Let me read it to you.
Yes.
This is literally exactly how my brain functions. And this is it's a thing of that you should strive for, according to the Chinese.
The Chinese. Yeah.
Once upon a time there was an old farmer who had worked his crops for many years. One day his horse ran away. Upon hearing the news, his neighbors came to visit. Such bad luck, they said sympathetically. You must be so sad. We'll see, the farmer said. The next morning the horse returned, bringing with it two wild horses. How wonderful, the neighbors exclaimed. Yeah. Not only did your horse return, but you received two more. What great fortune you have.
We'll see,
answered the farmer. The following day, his son tried to ride one of the untamed horses, was thrown, and broke his leg. The neighbors came to offer their sympathy of the misfortune. Now your son cannot help you with your farming. What terrible luck you have.
We'll see,
the farmer replied. The following week, military officials came to the village to conscript young men into the army. Seeing that his son's leg was broken, they passed him by. The neighbors congratulated with great luck.
We'll see.
The man smiled to himself and once again said, I will see.
Then the next day, a fucking tsunami hits and he's dead. But if he was off at war, he would have survived. What great luck, man.
We'll see.
We'll see. We'll see is the new motto.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes.
We'll see.
That's been my motto, motherfucker.
Yeah, we'll
that's see. The motto when we're YOLO.
Yeah. That is the best, most absolutely apathetic way to go through life. Like, hey, you should be excited about this. Nah. Hey, you should be really upset about this.
Maybe. We'll see.
Just
looking at it, baby. You're looking at it in the flesh.
I've always said this about myself, and I think I got to give the title to you. Like, the reason why, because people will be like, you know, come on. No, you guys, like, you're talented. This is, like, impressive. And I'm like, no, not really. And the reason why this works is I've always said about myself, so the other shows I've done, is just I'm the most middle-of-the-road man ever. Yeah. I'm just medium through and through, you know? just never high, never low, never good, never bad, never successful, never failure, never talented, never not talented. But you might truly be just. You are the 50th percentile for everything. You know, there, half the population is above and half is below, and you are just right there in the middle. You are the mean, the median, and the average, brother. Like the man, the myth, the legend, I'm the mean, the median, and average. John Feidelberg, the most average, middle, medium man to ever walk the face of the earth.
With a fuckboy pass.
With the fuckboy pass might make you special.
Yeah.
God. I'm telling you that single guys should just make, like, just pretend that you're John. Play this card and be like, my therapist told me that my brain is so broken that I don't know how to love and I can't be loved and I can't stick around and I can't be romantic and all of these things. I mean, by the way, this is also the self-proclaimed romantic. This is the man who says, I'm a romantic. And he's also romantic. Like, I can be a fuckboy. I'm allowed, I'm a doctor prescribed fuckboy, but you're a romantic?
Yeah. It's also like
I guess that kind of checks out because you could be a heavy romantic and then ditch a chick and then it's like you're being a, I guess you almost need to be a romantic at times to be the fuckboy.
Exactly right.
So yeah, so the actual, you know what you are when it comes to this? For everything else, you're middle of the road, like you don't care. But the reason why you end up in the middle of the road on this shit is because you go to this extreme and then this extreme, and it averages out to the middle.
Also true.
Everything else, you never really go to the extremes. But for this stuff, it's like, I love you, I'll fuck you. And then it's like, I don't really care.
Yeah,
and then you end up averaging out right back to the middle.
Fuck boy.
So why even, don't even bother going that way. Just have the passport and be like, we know we're going to end up right here. So let's just stay right here. Let's
do it. Dude, and I also respect the fact that, like, she's just like, yeah, I wouldn't, like, it's not for you, and, like, you just don't know how to use your brain. And I'm like, wait, isn't it your job to fix this?
I
rolled into the shop with a car, and they're just, like, totaled.
Broken.
And I'm like, yeah. No, the fucking, it's just got a bad tire.
I think
like, that doesn't work.
I think I've heard this a couple times from you recapping therapy, and so I can't decide whether you have the worst therapist in the world or if you are truly a specimen. Because I think, isn't this, I feel like your therapist did something else where she, like, gave up and was like, never mind.
Oh, she gives up every week. Every single week. I have.
You know what you found? You have found you in a therapist, yeah, who's like, I don't know. We'll see.
Dude, I
like you can pour your guts out, and your therapist goes like, we'll see. We're out of time. We'll see what happens next week.
We've never run out of time. She leaves before. We've never run 45 minutes.
She leaves early?
She's like, look, I think we've really kind of maxed out today, huh? I'm like, yeah, I agree.
I need to interview your therapist. Can we do something where you sign off your, like, confidentiality? We won't talk about your real issues, but I want to talk to her about you and just hear her be like, yeah, this fucking guy, I don't know. I need a behind the blog with John's therapist.
I think wouldn't be out of the... I think, I don't know her well. I've only known her for a year. But I would definitely be down to have her come on and be like, tell everyone I'm fucked up by him. Like, I'm not making it up. Tell him.
And you don't need to give me like the specifics, but you could just be like...
Yeah, the specifics? Yeah. Sure, go ahead, tell him.
It's amazing. It's truly amazing that, you know, we'll see is so inspiring. It's such a great way to be, though.
Look.
Never get too high, never get too low, just like, we'll see.
Yeah, this book is still unwritten.
Is that Natasha Bedingfield?
Yeah. I was going to say, we're just
the but, rest but, like, is still unwritten.
But wait, why do we just quote Natasha? Just because you wanted to?
That's just another way to say, we'll see. The rest is still unwritten.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I feel that.
Natasha. Chinese proverb. Natasha Bedingfield.
I can see. we're gonna get to a point where Feidelberg is like on his deathbed, you know? And I'll be like, dude, it's over for you. Maybe I'll say.
Maybe not.
You could win Powerball.
Bro, my grandfather died like 7 times. That dude was on his deathbed. Like, got to the point where it's like, bro, come on, man. Like, I've come to say goodbye to you a million times.
Was that the mushrooms?
Yeah.
Yeah.
On my deathbed, I was
played possum so many times. You cried wolf so many times that we were doing heavy drugs when you were, quote unquote, on your deathbed. We'll see.
We'll see.
Well, we saw. Yeah. We saw psychedelic fucking hallucinations on the wall at your funeral. We saw. God damn. I'm so happy because I really did not like our last episode. I just didn't think I was like, ugh. I was like getting back into it. I felt like rusty.
Oh, that was a great episode.
Yeah, it was the first time that I've ever really walked up being like, ugh, I don't know about that. But now I like this one a lot. this one's great. And it's brought to you by FreeFly, which is perfect because it's one of my favorite clothing brands that we work with. They've got the... the best swishy, soft pants that you can rock. All of FreeFly is made for like fly fishing and outdoor stuff, where it's got like the shirts that like have SPF coverage, and they're made for the outdoors with moisture wicking.
It's bamboo, right?
Yeah,
little bamboo material.
The shirts
material.
I had, the bamboo shirts. I don't know how they take bamboo sticks and turn them into soft shirts, but they're a little bit stretchy. But I have the Henley, so it's actually a little bit stylish. It's outdoor performance gear, but it's also like indoor lounge gear and stylish enough you can wear it out. The pants that I have are like these loungy pants, but also look kind of like khakis from a distance, so you can wear those out. And again, if you want to go fishing and hunting and hiking, these are all clothes that you can wear for that. So whether you're an indoors guy or an outdoors guy, FreeFly has got you covered. The soft bamboo is I mean, it's like a, this, like, it's a cool as well. It's like a cool, like, you put it on. It's like, you know what it is? FreeFly bamboo shirts are the equivalent of when you flip your pillow over and you get the cool side of the pillow.
Great marketing,
right?
Kevin.
That one's free, FreeFly. Next one's going to cost you, okay? Yeah. So get the bamboo shirts, get the comfy pants. They've also got, like nice pants that are, like, button up, wear it with a belt, like, you know, nice outfit type shit. So you can kind of do it all. Dress it up, dress it down, indoor, outdoor. When you go to freeflyapparel.com/KFC and you'll get 20% off that order. That's freeflyapparel.com/KFC. So we'll get into Am I the Asshole and our voicemails. But first, I've got a listener submission. And I will run through it with you. I feel bad because he submitted this a couple weeks ago, and I said we'll do it on the show, and I just never did. So we're a little late.
That's about our MO. He should have expected that.
Yeah. He knows.
Did we say that we're gonna do something? Probably.
Yeah. Do we not follow through on something? Sunny.
Sorry, I don't know how my brain works. Yeah. Okay.
You just got a free pass to be dumb.
Yeah, I got a free pass to be dumb and a slut. Yeah. It's awesome.
Imagine someone's like, Feidelberg's such a dumb slut. It's like, well, the doctor prescribed it.
Yeah, like
House's diagnosis. He's a dumb slut.
Actually, we prefer to go by broken brain fuckboys.
Oh, we'll see. Well, he's a broken brain fuckboy. We'll see. I was thinking about, like, what? Imagine if you didn't know how to use your other important organs. Imagine if I just breathe. If I was just like,
I don't know how to use my cock either.
Yeah, there's a lot of things we don't know how to use.
I don't know how to use my brain, heart, or cock. I am just a bag of worthless meat.
I don't know how to use my brain, my heart, or my cock. I mean, what is left? What is left? Over the age of like 18, like, you could have like said, oh, I play sports. Like, after that's gone, it's like nothing. You got nothing. You can't think, you can't fuck, and you can't feel. That is quite literally, no, wait. Quite literally, the three things that make you a human. Your ability to think, your ability to feel, and your ability to like procreate and like fuck. You can't, you're
can't
not a human.
I can't do any
you're
of them.
Not a human, John. You can't think.
You argued this for a while. We might have empirical evidence at this point.
Yeah. Yeah, for real. Like, we have proven it. We have doctors saying so.
You know, you're not like, you're a human. Hair.
You don't sweat. You don't have the hair.
What if I'm actually an alien?
What
How
if you
dope
are
would that be?
Have you ever done, like, no, you never done the DNA testing, right?
No.
We should do that, and the company would be like, no match. No, like, it broke the whole thing.
I'd still be like 0.03% Sub-Saharan African, though, just so I could brag about it.
Because everyone is. Yeah. Everyone's got it.
Just so I could post on my Instagram story, like, fucking everybody.
You're either not human, or you're like the missing link, you know what I mean? Or maybe you're, you know what? You would also could argue, the broken brain thing is tough, but I would say, you could make the argument that...
Boy, if you were just smart, we can make a real argument here.
If you were smart, you would be an alien. I would be down with the alien thing. Because your heart and your cock are two very, in my mind, like, primitive things. Like, couldn't you see aliens being like, these foolish humans experience love? That's so irrational and such a waste of time. And would you believe that they still have sex with their dicks? Like you know, like in Demolition Man, where you put the thing on your head and that's how you have sex?
I've never seen that.
Demolition Man, instead of having sex, you just put like a band on your head and it like makes you cum. So that's what like the future is. So I could see them being like, He doesn't
Can
use
you
his.
You believe they still have sex with their dick?
Hey, yes, and but all of this is because they are so advanced mentally, whereas you are.
Or am I evolved? I don't know things. Sure.
No, you're not. You're not. Let's. I don't. You don't know anything,
bro. I have reached Chinese proverb enlightenment. My meditation fucking Dalai Lama levels. I shut my brain off all the fucking time.
Yeah, that you're good at.
But so I'm enlightened like a higher being.
But you don't. You also don't. You don't like do anything with that. So you meditate and like. But what do you do with your brain power that's so like heightened?
Podcast. Successful podcast, Kevin.
Which, by the way, is the last, like, you've been, your whole life, you've been, like, growing into a fuckboy. And then the last one was, I have a podcast. So that when you can finally say that to girls at the bar or whatever, I have a podcast, and they're like, fuckboy. And for anybody who doesn't believe it, bam, card-carrying member of the fuckboy society.
I have a podcast and the StockX app. What's up, ladies?
You are either 100% fuckboy or like 99% alien, or maybe that's somewhere in between. Yeah. Those things overlap. Wow, we'll see, man.
This is fun and sad.
Yeah. Oh, I got a before I read the reader DM, I got one more. The reader had a question, but I also just got this one dude who just gave me some thoughts. Oh, this was when I was on vacation. He said to me, I hope you're doing well. You need the break, which is one of those things that's like, you look tired. Yeah. When people tell you that you need a break from your career, it's like, Jesus Christ, dude. So he started out with that. And then today he followed up with, I always thought you and Feits being depressed on the show was somewhat of an act, but I really don't think so anymore. I hope you get better and let the help you need come and stop lying to your therapist. I'm just really reading this for the first time now. I replied to it, but I didn't really read it. How about fuck you, dude? How about fuck you?
Thanks, man. Really appreciate the... Wait a second.
I mean, God damn.
That's like when you see someone.
You get better and let the help you need come and stop lying.
And you instinctively you instinctively throw the hand up and then realize, wait, they said fuck you, Feidelberg.
Yeah, man. Oh, no.
Stop. Oh, wait.
Yeah, these guys. What, you think you know me? Fuck you. Okay. Back to the question or the situation, let's call it. Here's a question you could have on the show. Is it possible that a picture of my soon-to-be ex-wife's asshole could save my marriage?
This is a reader DM?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
Why
don't you show it to me on design?
Believe me, thought about it. Thought about asking for the evidence. My wife and I filed for divorce a few weeks ago, but it's been in the works for a couple years. The problems we had in our marriage were primarily financial, where she always spent way more money than our budget allowed and racked up credit card debt, often without my knowledge, on cards I had no idea about. She also complained about me drinking too much. Once a week with my friends seemed like a lot to her because she's not a drinker. There's no way this guy was just going out once a week. Sex was infrequent, but great whenever we had it. Our two kids cock-blocked us a lot over the last 3 years. Since finalizing our decision to get divorced in January, her sex drive has been insane. She wanted to fuck me pretty much every day, multiple times a day, and she's telling me she can't fathom losing me. I regularly remind her of the problems that led us to this point, and she always responds with, quote, I'm going to regret losing you forever if I do. I moved out 2 weeks ago, and the sex is still happening 2 to 3 times a week when she pushes to come over to my house or for me to come over to hers. Last night, she let me take pictures of her after sex for me to, quote, jerk off to while we're not together. I have to admit, this is Jackie earmuffs. I have to admit, I lost my spot. Where is it? I have to admit, the picture of her spreading her ass cheeks is making me question if I should get divorced. It's the hottest fucking thing she has ever done, and the picture is top notch. I still realize we have a lot of problems, but shit like this makes my dumb brain see past all that, because anyone else getting to enjoy that would infuriate me. Can't tell if she's doing this to get back together with me or further ruin my life. So I ask again, is it possible?
Oh, women.
There is so much jam-packed in here. Like, first of all, this
dude...
I can't
tell if she's doing this because she loves me or hates me.
That is incredible.
It's basically every relationship ever.
The fact that that is so common that men would have that in their brains, like, you're either doing something that is so incredibly selfless and loving and amazing, or it's the most diabolical plot I've ever heard of in my life. And it is a coin flip on which one it could be. That's crazy. It's also crazy that this man listed out the most serious of relationship issues. Drinking
all
problems, financial problems, doing things behind my back, lying to me. I mean, check, all of the worst of the worst. And then the thought that all of that might be erased by a picture of her asshole, while ridiculous, is an entirely reasonable question.
100%.
Because that type of sex and that single picture. Oh, and then the last thing, which is so normal and real and a major issue, is not even the thought necessarily of like, oh man, she's so hot, I want her. It's, I don't want anyone else to have her.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, I'm over
very,
this chick.
Very, very
but
controlling.
I don't want someone else. Yeah, super manipulative, super controlling. But the thought of like, oh man, she's going to fuck someone. Like, especially like you've been together. When you're with somebody and you like turn them out, you figure each other's sex lives out like together, you know what I mean? And you turn them into like a freak, and then it's like, and now someone else just gets to reap that. Yeah. Fuck that. Like it's almost like you know when they sell, you know, when you sell NFTs, you might not know this. So if you make an NFT, and then someone buys it from you, if that next person sells it, you still get
10%.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
You should get 10% of the sex of your exes.
Yeah.
So
it's like I gave you job training. You can't go work somewhere else.
Exactly.
You have to work here.
You know what it's like? It's like when you in finance, if you work for a company and they pay for your MBA, you have to work for them. Because they're like, we're not gonna pay for your schooling, and then you just bounce and go to another firm. Right. So I'm not gonna turn you in to like a porn star and then some other guy, night one, gets the full fucking treatment. Fuck that. Yeah. Unless like every now and then you have to come back and fuck me like once a month. You know what I mean? I get 10% of the sex. So tell your new boyfriend once a month, you have to fuck me, and it's because it's a good deal, trust me, because you're gonna get it every other night. You know, you get it the other 29 days a month. Because of the work I did. So I understand this guy from top to bottom. I get all of it.
They must have just been like, they must be kind of like high school sweethearts, right? Or college.
That's what I'm thinking, yeah.
Because like, guess what, dude? They all have assholes.
I was going to say, you can get pictures of assholes, you know? But
everyone's got an asshole.
Now, but I'll say this. Not all assholes are created equal.
No, that's true.
There are some pictures you do not. I'm like, close those cheeks up. You know? Squeeze them together. I don't want to see that.
That's why like, I think like amateur porn is such
hit or miss.
A gift to society. Yeah. It's like, just so you know, don't always expect the porn star asshole.
And boy, there's nothing quite like, what's a good comparison? Perhaps pizza? No, What's a good comparison for like
the good ones are good and the bad ones are bad?
Tuna sandwich.
Tuna assholes are like tuna. You know, they're either gonna be like, wow, this is great.
This is,
or it's like, oh my god. I don't ever want to even look at that thing, let alone eat it. What?
I'm just holding down a gag right now. Okay, I think we're good. I think we're past it.
But so when this guy's got a good tuna sandwich on his hands, okay, and it's his and it's hers, you know, it's theirs together, and while I will say there's other you can get other pictures, you got to put in some work before you get a casting couch. Spread your cheeks. Spread your cheeks is intimate.
You got to put in a few babies. It seems.
Yeah, right. Apparently you have to be like married.
I do like it is like I think it's guys and girls, which is like everything is wrong with this relationship. But I might get horny later.
Yeah. it really is the horny police should be an actual thing. What a great skit that would be. Like they bust down your door with the fucking barricade thing, and there's a dog who comes in with a little mini bat and actually hits you before you text your ex, before you stay in a marriage that is clearly horrific. Just because you can get your fuck on.
Dude, anytime
the
you
horny
say
you, police the, actually hitting you with a real bat would be unbelievable.
It is crazy the power people have over one another. We're like, you like the man said our divorce has been years in the making. I haven't been happy since fucking Obama was in office, the guy said. And then he goes, that butthole, pretty good.
That asshole. I mean, it is the power that it has over people is nuts. Like, you lose your brain. You lose your mind.
Yeah.
This, like if this, I would love to, if this here man got this story from another friend, like, financially, trust-wise, like, happy, like everything, catastrophic. But should I stay together for her butthole? You'd be like, fucking no. But when you're in it, you're like, well, maybe, like, you know, hear me out, guys. I mean, the decision-making process.
I feel like it's not fair that he didn't show us the picture. I gotta know.
I'm gonna text him right now.
I think
it's only fair. Swear to God, that you show us the picture.
We check the spokes on that wagon wheel.
If he sends it to us, I'm gonna say that. I'm not gonna say it now because I might. We are discussing now. But need the full info.
By that, I mean
harassment.
We gotta see if this axle is worth changing if we're gonna go to California.
So, I pose the question to you, Feidelberg. Is it possible and is it reasonable to, you know, maybe to save this marriage?
It's completely unreasonable, but understandable.
It's understandable, and it's possible.
You think it's possible?
No. They're doomed. But I think it's entirely possible that, and we're really specifying the picture situation here, but I'm bigger picture. I think it's entirely possible that the sex, I know this for a fact. What I'm about to say is not novel. Sex can keep you in a relationship that you should not be in.
Oh, yes.
So this is, we are now, like, we are at the 11th hour here. We're at DEFCON 1, whatever phrase you want to use. So it's bad, but... And ain't it always the way? It's like, if you just fucked him like you did in the last, like, in the last minutes of this horrible relationship, if you just did that regularly, and you guys had this feeling of jumping each other's bones and being open and, hey, let me take pictures for you. And, you know, that's all the stuff. That's all raunchy, but it's what it is going out of your way for another person. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. So it's like if you had just done this and if he had shown the same interest and the same, like, oh, my God, you're so hot, you guys probably would be happy. But you waited until it's too late.
But
like every relationship has that moment where it's kind of like, well, it's too late now. It's too little too late. But it's like if he had done this earlier.
You think that conquers... I think that people who like to drink and people who don't drink cannot be in a relationship together.
That's true. So you're saying because he goes out and...
I think you can be... Actually, yeah, I don't think... I guess because a recovering alcoholic is always going to see signs of like, well, that's how I was. Like, no, I just like having a fucking beer.
You were
fucking waking up in like sewers.
Right.
You're right. I got drunk last night. I got home. I came in bed. Whatever. Like...
If you're a drinker, you would understand that. And if you're not, you're going to be like, what the fuck?
Right.
Yeah. I also think there's just something to, you know, I think when women, especially once you're becoming a mom and you're getting pregnant, there's like months and years at a time you're not drinking while someone else still is. I think it just becomes a whole dynamic that gets like fucked up. So I think that, and then on top of that, if you're just not a drinker, period. I agree with you. What I'm saying here is I agree with you. I think television, I've always said, like being on the same page TV-wise is hugely important. And I think same thing like socially. And it doesn't even necessarily have to be drinking. Like, I mean, just like, do you go out and I don't sort of thing?
Right.
Then it's going to be, especially usually stereotypically with girls, it's like, have you seen, there's like a viral TikTok that was like, when girls are about to go on a girls' weekend, or it starts off the other way. When guys are going on a guy's weekend, it's like, where are you going? Who are you going to be with? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? And he's like trying to get out the door and answering a million questions. And then with the girls, it's like, hey, I'm going on the girls' weekend. He's like, okay, babe. She's like, don't you want to know? I'm like, okay, bye. Like, get the fuck out. Get the fuck out. So I think any sort of imbalance in that partying and or social life, yeah, I agree, is going to be a problem. Let me see if he DM'd us back. So, what would you tell this guy? Like, what's your?
I would say move to a new town. You can't be that close to clearly this man is addicted to his wife's pussy.
And no, yeah, you almost do have to recognize that, like, I can't be around you. I can't be. Yeah. That's where the problem is with the phone. Because, like, we joke in the past about, like, when you used to break up, you just moved to another town, and then that's gone. She's gone. But also, like, protecting yourself, where it's just like, well, I can't reach her anymore. You know? Like, I'll move, and then I won't even be tempted by you because you're not around.
Yeah, but if we're talking more.
But if I can just get that asshole on the phone, then, like.
But it's still like a plane ride away? Too far. I'm not doing it. Mm-hmm. It's like an addict realizes that they're in an uncomfortable situation. This situation might not be healthy.
I got to go.
I'm going to get out of here.
Yeah, it's not you.
Get out of town.
Yeah. Go. But the technology can keep you at least, like, he can maybe move on and be in another relationship. But if all of a sudden there's going to be, like, well, you still got that on your phone every now and then, you're going through your camera roll and you're like, oh,
yeah,
that could be a problem. Well, let me just tell you that, you know, the update. So he sent that to me, you know, that was on 4/14. And then just yesterday, update, the pic did not save my marriage. So there is a conclusion to the story here. The answer here in this situation was no, it was not enough. So that's why I really want to see
shocked.
I said, well, that's for the best. And he said, I agree. But I would love to see the picture because I'll be like, I could have been like, yeah, I could have told you that's not enough. That wasn't enough. So there you have it, folks. Score one for the horny police on that one. You know, like they bonked you and you stayed broken up, and it's probably for the best. Maybe we'll hear a tale soon of the opposite where, you know, a nude pics was
that's
able
what
to
the bonk's
keep,
for. The bonk concusses you and you forget.
And you forget. Oh, you knock well. You knock that horniness out of your head. Yeah. So score one for the horny police. Am I the asshole time?
Let's do it. Speaking
that's,
of.
Yeah, very. That's how you segue. Am I the Asshole is brought to you by HelloFresh.
Yay.
Yay. Tell the people what you've been cooking recently,
Let's
bud.
Let's see what we got on deck.
Number one HelloFresh user on the planet. No exaggeration.
Have to be. Okay, coming up this week. Monterey Jack unfried chicken. Don't know what it is. I imagine it's a crispy chicken that I don't fry.
Chicken?
I even asked my mom what it was. She's like, I don't know, but it looks delicious.
It's
going to
be a healthy version of fried chicken. That's awesome.
With buttery green beans, potato wedges, and sriracha mayo.
Oh, sriracha mayo. Drown me in that.
Beef tenderloin with mushroom sauce, roasted Brussels sprouts, and potatoes. Yup. And then finally, a quick meal I got. This one's a rapid, only 5-minute prep, 15-minute total time to cook. Easy bean cheesy chicken quesadillas with smoky red pepper crema. It is fire.
That's just
15
for this week.
Minutes
a meal, and he's going to get all of those for this week. He's eating like a goddamn king, and it all comes right to his door in a box with all the ingredients pre-portioned, pre-packaged, so you don't have to be How much do I put? You put the whole thing in. They give you just the right amount, so you're not doing a pinch or a dash. Put it in, follow the instructions, and it's coming out to perfection.
When I used to cook, like back in college, I cooked a lot, and I'd go and I'd be like, oh, this recipe needs this. Guess what? Spend like $20 on that fucking olive oil or whatever.
And you use a fraction of it.
And I never see it again.
Yep.
They just give you exactly what you need. Mm-hmm. It is, I mean, I cannot tell. And again, it is actually an awesome meditative thing. It's therapeutic. Mm-hmm. You're just like, I know exactly what to do. I'm following instructions. I'm not playing on my phone.
You know what I said?
Music, have a nice glass of wine.
When people say, make your bed, I'm like, fuck that. They're like, you know, you accomplish a task. I'm like, shut up. But I think cooking actually is a worthy task. That you're like, I did this start to finish. It's a reward. I'm eating. It like it checks a lot of boxes. Like, I did it. I need to eat. It's good. I accomplished it. It was kind of fun. I learned. Cooking is basically therapy.
Yeah. You know? It really is. Yeah. It's very therapeutic to do.
And when you're talking, you know, it can be Kraft burgers and gourmet meals.
And it's crazy if you don't do this. First of all, because you get like probably $500
worth
of free meals.
12 free meals when you go to HelloFresh.com/KFC12. Use code KFC12 for 12 free meals with free shipping. So not only do you get that.
I'm doing the math right now. Again, I did $30 for an order. Actually, wait, no, because it's 24. It's 24 because the meals are double portioned.
Right.
So 25 times 30. This is a $720 ad deal.
It's crazy.
Promo code.
I love it.
$720. Tony Hawk does 720s. We do 720s for you.
It should be hashtag Tony Hawk. HelloFresh, hashtag Tony Hawk. It's the most trusted meal kit company in the world right now. And you can get those 12 free meals when you go to HelloFresh.com/KFC12. Am I the asshole? These are also reader submissions or something like that? Or no, did I make that up? Okay, whatever. Josh, can you do me a favor? Can you just go around the corner and turn down the fucking AC?
Yeah.
Just turn it down to 68. Don't let anybody stop you. It's like right by the hallway to the bathroom, like right where Mackenzie and them sit. You'll see it on the wall. I have a thought before we do this. I'm gonna fucking buy all the girls here who are cold space heaters. Everybody gets a space heater, and we're keeping this shit at 66 degrees.
It is. I don't.
Because I get it. They sit at their desk and do their work. I'm sitting here yelling and screaming and getting animated. I'm gonna be hot and sweating. So we're never gonna be good on the temperature ever. So I will get you space heaters, but I'm keeping that shit at 66.
It's very fair.
Fuck that.
It is
right?
Actually crazy. I remember there was an article probably a few years back. It was in the New York Times that like the air conditioning in office buildings is sexist or something like that. Do women just run colder?
Apparently. Yep.
Which I don't understand because whenever a woman lays on me, it's like a fucking furnace. They are like they're the hottest fucking people.
Now when they're in the office, they're freezing cold. I mean, I'm about to pass out. I'm feeling physically ill right now.
I mean, me too.
Like, I think I'm going to puke.
It's so fucking hot.
And I walk out there and they're like bundled up. I'm like, you've got to be fucking kidding me. This is not humanly possible. It's like they are lizards or snakes on a rock under on a lamp that they need to just like sit there and bake and be warm. It's insane.
But their bodies are so hot. How are you cold when you're that hot? It doesn't make
it's
any
a Chinese
sense.
Riddle for you. I just don't get it. I mean, I feel like I'm actually going to puke.
You want to take a break?
No. Let's go. Am I the asshole? We got some good ones here. I identify as a submissive, and my BDSM identity is very important to me. My sister's getting married soon, and I'm a bridesmaid. She wants me to remove my collar for the wedding and the photos, but my collar is a sign of my commitment to my master. It's like asking her to take off her wedding ring. She said it's creepy, and she doesn't want it to be reminded of it, of my weird sex life on her wedding day. I was really insulted and told her I don't want to remove it. Who's the biggest asshole?
Well, I am going to say the woman in the dog collar is the asshole.
I think it's a pretty reasonable request to remove your fuck collar. Okay? I mean, you know, I actually really appreciate the spin zone. Of this is like a sign of my commitment, the same way it's your wedding ring. The thing about the wedding ring.
I do tip the cap to that.
Yeah.
It's a good spin.
But the wedding ring is not a conduit, a device for hardcore sex. You know?
It's love.
If you were wearing on your, if it was like a cock ring on your finger, then maybe we could draw a comparison. But the sex collar in public, it's just, you know, no, we're not there yet.
It is. It's actually a great like comparison or juxtaposition with religion, where the old one, the one that's been around forever, that's totally normal.
Right.
Right. And then, but then fucking Scientology, that's
wacko.
Bizarre. Yeah, it's so weird. Yeah.
Well, this is a cult.
The ring has been around forever.
So it's just
the collar is new. I saw a girl on the subway the other day wearing a collar. And I don't think it was sexual. It just said, I am trying.
like a thick collar.
No, I don't know. I wouldn't say it was super thick. But it
just
was
big enough.
It was. And it wasn't a necklace. It was a collar. And it just said, dude, I am trying. I get it.
That's great.
Like, I saw it. I just gave it, I don't even think she saw me. But I just saw it. Like, it's like she earned a nod. Okay. Like, it wasn't like we had eye contact. I was like, this girl, you're doing it, girl. You're doing it.
I am like, failing, but I am trying.
Even like the fact that it's not trying. It was I am trying.
I'm another fucking t-shirt. We'll see, and I am trying. I'll wear the collar. I might wear the fucking collar. That is great.
That was a wild subway ride. The guy next to me was doing, I swear to God, this is true. He took out his phone and opened the calculator app and did 1,700 minus 700.
Thank you. 1,700 minus 700.
And he was holding his phone out like this. Like, well, like he wanted people
John
to see.
John is making fun of your mathematical abilities.
If you're doing math like that, you better have your phone in like you're sending a cock pic.
Can I?
Like, it's just like, don't be sharing that with the world. 1,700 minus 700.
Bro, did you see this tweet? Somebody, speaking of math, this person tweeted, It was just a tweet like, here's a math problem. Tell me how you do this math problem.
Okay.
Did you see that?
Yes. I forget the numbers.
It was like
47 plus 26.
Yeah. 20. How do you do 28 plus 47?
28 plus 47.
How do you? I mean, it's interesting. How do you do it?
I do 28 plus 47. So I would do 20 plus 40.
You do that. Huh?
60. And then 8 plus 7. Yeah. Because I wouldn't be able to do
so
it.
So if you do 20 plus 40, everyone knows that's 60. 8 plus 7 is 15.
So 75, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just do like 8 plus 7 and then carry the 1 over the
I change the numbers for sure.
I mean, that's pretty astounding that you actually do that. I feel like that's a very new age way to, like, the kids do that.
That's not Common Core math. Is it Common Core? Is that what it's called?
I think so. Yeah.
That's Common Core math. I guess that's how I've always
find
done
the
in my
one,
head.
Though. There's one person who replied here that's like, this is fucking insanity. It was like, I do 2 plus 4, and I hold the 6, and then... Let me try to find it, because it was absolutely nuts. People out here do some wacky shit. Like, one person did 47 plus 3 plus 28 minus 3.
What?
Like, wacko shit that just makes it that much harder. But, yeah, some people... I do 2 plus 4 equals 6. Then I take the 8 and keep taking away from the 7 until my 8 is now 10. I add the 1 from that 10 to the 6, so it's now 7. Then I leave what's left of the old 7, now 5, to my new 7, 75. What?
Bro,
like, no, you just made that shit
the
up.
The moment you started saying things, my brain went, nah. Mm. Like we'll check out for the next... Let's rest for the next 10 seconds, because...
I mean, that's just... Anyway, back to the BDSM collar. you just can't wear a sex collar to a wedding unless it's Dave Bortnoy's.
Federal crime!
I was home with my girlfriend, and this guy on TV made some joke about peeing in the shower. And she said, ew, and I said... You never pee in the shower? She got really upset with me and said I'm disgusting. She made me go and clean the shower with bathroom bleach and swear to never do it again. I just wanted to chill after work and now I'm scrubbing tiles. Who's the biggest asshole?
The wife. If you don't rip a piss in the shower, I have like a Pavlovian instinct to piss in showers. The second
it's like, I don't even have to pee it, I'm like, let's go.
Bro, it's why I have to use umbrellas. If I get rain on me, I piss my pants.
Any sign of water, I'm peeing.
It's like, yeah. If I get wet, I have to piss. It's just, I actually don't think that's crazy. I started it as a joke, but now like I'm like I jump in a pool, I gotta pee right away.
By the way, I heard you talking about how you get morning wood because your dick's filled with pee.
Yes.
It's not really wrong.
What? No,
right?
I think
we get hard to stop us from peeing the bed.
I think
that's an actual thing that our bodies do.
As
it's not filled with pee, but
I rip a piss, it's like a balloon slowly deflating. it's just like that's how told you my cock doesn't work to start the show.
This can't possibly be a surprise, folks. I told you this.
I wake up hard every morning until I pee.
Let's do one more here.
I'm gonna look down the barrel on this one. I am not kidding. I wake up every morning fully erect and filled with piss.
Heavens to Betsy. All right, last one. I don't want to talk about your dick filled with piss.
No, we're not doing that anymore. I'm talking about chicks in the shower. Hey, chicks, piss in the shower.
Come on, just pee in the shower, and I promise you it'll be so much better.
That's another example, I think, of how women just don't understand how peeing works because their vaginas pee so weird. Like, I'm pissing right down the drain. Don't worry. What do you think? I'm fucking spraying it all? No.
No, it just
I got like a that. Fucking nozzle on my hose. Yeah, you're the one who fucking pisses all over the room.
Right. You're hitting the walls and the ceiling. You're the one making a mess. I'm just going right in the hole. All right. I've always been self-conscious about the shape of my nose. So now I'm an adult and I'm at my parents' house. And I decided to get a nose job. I'm out of my parents' house. I don't have all the I don't have all the funds, so I crowdfunded part of it. I wasn't specific. I just said a life-improving operation, and a bunch of people helped. My sister found out, and she thinks I've tricked them into thinking it's life-saving. And she wrote this whole post on Facebook saying, don't give her any money. It's just for vanity. I don't think I lied to anyone. She thinks I'm the dick.
Who's the biggest asshole?
This is interesting. I think this one... I like it. It's sneaky. But I do think it's shady.
It's...
I want to see the full... I need to see the full GoFundMe. Because if it says, like...
I need to see the nose.
Oh, okay. That's fair. How bad the nose is.
By the way,
it might be life-saving.
Speaking of noses, you see that New York Post report? A very esteemed publisher.
If you got a big fat nose, you're
you
like...
got a big fat cock. We've said cock a lot.
You've said cock a lot, and I've just gone... No,
you started with the cock ring.
No.
Yeah.
No, way before that, you said my brain and my heart, my cock don't work.
I did say that.
Yeah, and okay. then I just went with the cock. I just went with it. So you started the cock trend.
I had cock on the brain.
We said cock like 60 times before I said cock ring. I'm not wearing that one. If it's a really bad nose and the GoFundMe said like, if the GoFundMe really made it sound like a disease, like a cancer thing, then you're shady. But if you just said... It's an operation that's gonna change my life and make me happy. I think it's a fair game.
I agree with you there. Because I'd be like, oh, this is plastic surgery. Like 100%.
Right.
If you were
or like you're
unless
transitioning
you specifically
or something.
Say yeah yeah that's
you know but
yeah.
you, that's
which is plastic surgery.
So
right?
like yeah, I think if you said that you donated to help someone pay for sexual transition, I think people would think that's like honorable, right?
For sure.
Well, why not? Like, I want to fix my nose because that makes me unhappy. It makes me uncomfortable in my skin. So why is that vanity versus transgender, you know? It's all just to make you happy and feel better.
I would, yeah. I think it's something psychological. I think it's fair.
Mm-hmm.
You're just like, this is not, when I look in the mirror, I don't see what I am. I want to fix this nose. That's the real me.
And those people don't need a few bucks.
I identify as a person with a better nose than this.
Yeah, yeah. I identify as a hot person, and I'm in an ugly body. So I need to transition. I think that's like, and then you know, people who donate to GoFundMe, like, I don't know, they're happy to do it, and you don't need to fucking call
yeah,
out
it's also
on it.
Like, it was $15. Shut
yeah,
up.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, if there was some person who like gave their life savings, thinking that they're gonna help you out of cancer, well, no, different story. But the people who donated $20.
It's also not the worst GoFundMe I've heard about today. He might have updated it or something. Hollywood Brown?
Yeah.
Did he have an update on that?
I didn't think about it, but he's once we're number 5, and number 5 is Joe Flacco's number, which is not retired, but like he's the
this dude on the Ravens wants to buy
in order to change your number in the NFL now, you know, they let players change their numbers now. In order to change to those numbers, you have to buy all of your jerseys in circulation.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and which is a bullshit fucking rule, because it's not like they make fucking franchises if they trade the player.
Right.
Like, it's not like they change, make them or cut the player. They don't make you buy them all. But I think they're doing it in order to dissuade players from changing their number.
All the time.
Which is such a... Then don't change the rule.
Right.
Like,
it
doesn't fucking matter.
Right.
But Hollywood Brown put out a GoFundMe this morning being like, donate to
me
so I can buy all my jerseys.
Yeah.
And I can change my number.
Bro, like, meanwhile, there's like, pictures of him at the jeweler, like being like tapping it up with like Jacob the jeweler. He bought a new piece. It's tough, but also, my thing is like, put your GoFundMe out, and if there are people dumb enough to do it, then so be it. Can't knock the hustle. Supply and demand, capitalism. If somebody wants to help you buy number 5, I think it's stupid. They don't.
I'm gonna see if he updated. Then it was like, yeah, my bad, guys.
He deleted the tweet.
Yeah, okay.
So he fucking knows. So yeah, maybe you don't have to like it, but you don't have to put up a Facebook post calling it out. You know what I mean? All right, we'll get into our voicemails in a minute, but first we're going to do some music submissions here for our new theme song. It's brought to you by Kraft Mayo. Do you love mayo? Velvety smooth mayo like this?
Mayo got a bad rep. I think I'm going to be in charge of rehabilitating mayo.
Oh, I think mayo's fine. I think mayo's delicious.
I think mayo's delicious.
Yeah.
I think mayo changes the game on a sandwich.
I think
you can have a bad sandwich, you pop mayo on it, great sandwich.
Everything becomes good. It's the new ultimate mayo for the mayo lovers. It's a mayo endorsement contract this season. So there's the mayo man who went viral in 2019. He's the ultimate personality who showed his love for mayo on the sporting world stage. Well, right now they're looking for the next super fan to sign them to a $10,000 mayo endorsement. Mayo endorsement now is what we're doing here, folks. For the mayo lovers who come up with the next iconic meme fame, for the first half of the month until May 14th, Kraft Mayo will be taking entries and submissions to be the next face of the brand for Kraft Mayo.
I think I just settled it.
I was going to say.
This is over. I win.
Feidelberg wins.
I win. Give me my 10 grand and we'll fucking do this.
Follow at Real Kraft Mayo and submit your best videos on why you should win the Mayo endorsement on Twitter and Instagram with hashtag Kraft Mayo endorsement.
My videos are just going to be me making delicious sandwiches.
You should just change your, instead of doing your milkshakes, you just get mayo all over while you do word of the month, word of the day. So follow at Real Kraft Mayo on Twitter and Instagram and submit your viral videos on why you should be the face of the brand. And go get yourself some delicious Kraft Mayo. Let's do our voice. Let's do our music submissions. What do we got? Let's just do a couple of them and then do voicemails. This one
is Billy Reimer. Billy Reimer. Oh, fucking Stickly Bill, they call him. Fuck if y'all gon' feel me. But you bought that fucking Cassie. Fuck if y'all gon' like I'm Clancy, chips are loud, I can't see. Ain't coming for your mom, I'll be coming on your head. Yeah, I ain't got a plan, trees, I just gotta smoke. Did you just say coming on my mom?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he did.
I gotta say, I don't think I'd like that to start my show. Tell me, Feidelberg, I think you fucked my out, bitch. But it's so good, dude. I'll be in a good mood. Crank it up and play me, bro. KFC the radio. Bitch, you bought that fucking KFC. Okay. I like the guitar. I like the, like, the beat.
I don't need this guy. It sounds like he's coming on my mom.
There is a
not only
little...
Did he say he was coming on my mom, it sounded like he was coming it's while a, he did
I,
it.
I was going to say at the very start, I thought it was I was going to give him time to maybe change tune. And I was going to be like, it sounds like he's coming right now. But that just seems to be his voice. Which, don't get me wrong, you can have a very extremely successful career, ask Billie Eilish. But the there is... It's heavy on the imagery of a man ejaculating.
That was too much. That was too.
Which
it was, you know, too like intimate. Too like sensual. That was too sensual.
I feel like he just fucked me.
Yeah.
Which is probably a compliment for a song.
I don't know.
But like, it's not. Not
when you don't
want
to get fucked
podcast,
by it. Yeah. No. Next.
Like that song did just come in me.
God damn, John.
This one is Matthew Rose. Oh, I think this guy put in your IG story. KFC Radio.
KFC. Oh, yeah, this guy. I'm Barstool. Don't be fooled. They're the real OGs. On your feet, listen
up. It's the big show. You already know. This sounds like the intro.
There's a song that sounds
to a Saturday morning,
yeah,
middle school cartoon, not
yeah,
childish, but maybe
yes,
Transformers or something
right,
that like.
Right.
And I mean this as a huge
compliment.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm with you. I know. I've heard that before.
Yeah.
That riff and that melody and that is a another show that's
not like some Rugrats shit, but
no,
like some
not
fucking,
some childish shit, some preteen shit.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like maybe this is like a Nick at Night, perhaps, or
which
the
is,
big red couch.
It kind of fits with what we are. It's like we're not men, you know, we're boys. So
right.
Like, that fits.
Yeah.
All right.
That's we'll put that in the let's revisit
that in the
pile.
Maybe. Yeah, yeah. 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 We'll do one more.
Yeah. All right. This is Jacob Cleaver.
Running Jake.
You've never put your dick on granite? Welcome to KFC Radio.
I'll let you palm your chicken.
Please watch the YouTube and watch us spit.
You're gonna be like, what the fuck, Feits?
Yes.
I'm sorry, okay? The day got away from me.
So let's move on and talk about some buttholes.
Okay. There is no
is there
way
any music or
is
just
okay?
This?
No,
I think it's just
this. I'm going to say, and this is going to be a criticism of the whole
quality
show.
Of it, yeah.
I don't care for me.
Yeah,
I could
less
use,
of us.
I could use less me.
Less us and more musical talent, please.
And that's a mantra for life. We've gone through a couple of mantras here. I could use a lot less.
Yeah, yeah, always. And so could the world.
Yeah.
So could the world. All right, so there's our musical submissions. If you want to get down and make us a new theme song, that's what we're looking for. So, you know, can be quick, short, sweet, can be a rap, could be, you know, instrumental, whatever. Get at us, and we'll and you might get a chance to be the new face of KFC Radio.
The email is kfcradiointro@gmail.com.
kfcradiointro@gmail.com. Now it's time for our voicemails. They're brought to you by Movement. Join the Movement this summer. Get yourself a Movement watch. Get yourself some Movement shades. Johnny's rocking his Ben Franklin spectacles right now.
I look
flip it up,
great.
And you. I didn't realize that when you flip those up, it still has glass there. I thought it was just like empty.
No, no. I mean, these are the real and deal, Holyfield.
Starts to rain, you got a little roof covering it there.
I'm still going to piss my pants, but.
And it's affordable, it's stylish, it matches the watches. The watches, they have all sorts of different bands, all sorts of different faces. They've got different colors. They've got for men, they got for women, all starting at just like $95, nothing higher than $130. I think the shades start around like $50 or $60. Get yourself a few pairs, match them to your sunglasses, match them to your watches, and you're going to be styling for the summer where you've got
profiling.
Styling and profile.
Do them both. Don't do one. Don't limit yourself.
Razzling
style
and dazzling.
And profile. Razzle and dazzle. Sunglasses and shades.
and watches.
And watches.
Spectacles and
timepieces. Sunglasses
and
shades are the same thing.
You're goddamn right.
I meant sunglasses and watches.
MVMT.com. That's like Movement. MVMT.com/KFC. Get 15% off today. Plus free shipping and free returns. That's MVMT.com/KFC.
I apologize to people on the show, just so people watching the show on the YouTube. I am just having an itchy penis day.
Oh. God damn it, John. Next. Play it, please. Fuck. God, I'm already sweating. I'm nauseous. Now I gotta think of that.
Well, better than yesterday, I was having an itchy butthole day.
Play the fucking DM. Play the voicemail.
I'm trying. It's getting drowned out by John's itchy butthole.
Damn it.
KFC, Feits, Super Producer BC, whoever's in the studio. So I just had a once-off drunken hookup with this girl who happens to be a listener of KFC Radio. Wow. She asked to borrow a shirt when we were done, so I grabbed the first one I saw and I gave it to her like a normal person would. But in my drunken stupor, I didn't realize that I gave her a shirt that is like seriously sentimental to me. So my question is, what's the worst or craziest thing you've lost to a drunken hookup, and do I have a chance of getting it back? Thanks. Viva.
I'm hung up on something here. Why did he have to tell us he gave it to her normally? How'd you really give her this shirt, dude?
What do you mean, get?
He's like, I gave her to like, almost wanted to, like, stave off any questions in the past. Where he's just like, I gave her a shirt, don't worry.
Don't worry, it was normally. Normal. Totally normal.
Like, and one way I know you don't do something normal is if you tell me before I have a chance to ask a question.
Yeah.
Like, bro, I wasn't going to ask you how you gave her a shirt. I fucking reasoned that one out in my head. Like, I gave her a shirt, don't worry, it was totally normal. Like, I did it like a normal person would. How'd you really give this to her?
How could you, how do you not normally give someone a shirt? What's the non-normal way to do it?
I know what you're thinking. No, it was a completely normal way to give her a shirt. Like, what'd you do? You hike into her? Bro, how did you give her this shirt?
Feits is hot. Feits wants to know.
I gotta know how you gave her this fucking shirt, dude.
Well, but
did you make her pull it out of your throat like a magician? Like, how did you give her this shirt, bro?
Oh my god!
Don't know. It was normal. It was normal. I did it normally.
Total normal transition. Transaction.
I know you're curious. I'm sure I gave it to her normal. I promise. It was normal. It was a normal. I just did it normally. I just did it, just a normal handing off of the shirt.
Do you think you could get it back?
Yeah, bring it to her house. Steal it.
I think you can just ask for it back.
I do. I think it's.
I think. I mean, we make a thing about the girls stealing the hoodies, and that happens. But I think if someone ever hit you up and was like, "Hey, by the way, that shirt's sentimental," you have to be a fucking asshole to not give that back.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, I think you shoot her a text. You say, "Hey, thanks for the pussy the other night."
But I'll tell you what, it was good pussy, but it wasn't worth my sweatshirt.
Using the emojis for this one?
Yo, girl, you had that good puss. Remember that shirt I handed you in a totally normal way?
How about you hand that back to me also in a totally normal way? How about you return it totally normal?
Look, I'm sure you forgot about this because it was so normal it probably didn't even register. But that shirt I gave you.
Next up, totally normal sweatshirt.
What up, KFC?
What the fuck was that? Was that a deep call? Wait till the voicemail picks
up. Start that over.
For him to go.
What up, KFC? Feits, Nick, Jackie, everyone else. Got a hypothetical for you. Don't know what made me think of this, but if you could only have one type of sandwich between peanut butter and jelly or grilled cheese for the rest of your life and the other one completely disappears, can never have it again, which would you choose? And this is including like any variations you want to make to it. You can add like lunch meat to the grilled cheese. You can add marshmallow fluff or honey and whatever you want to the peanut butter and jelly. But the other one is gone forever. What do you choose?
That's a good question. Those are two powerhouse sandwiches, but I'm taking peanut butter and jelly every time.
Taking peanut butter and jelly without question, without hesitation.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a matter. I do love a really good grilled cheese, but just the idea of you got to cook it and it's a whole thing. Whereas I whip up peanut butter and jelly on the regular for breakfast, lunch, dinner, for snacks.
I very rarely eat either, but I got to have the PB&J in my bag.
Definitely.
Although I did have a grilled cheese the other day. I forget where
they're
I was.
They're so good. They're delicious.
It came with tomato soup.
Yeah.
It was a spicy tomato soup, and you dipped it grilled. And
that's the thing.
Boy,
that
was fucking. Mm.
The grilled cheese is almost like a meal, you know? Whereas I need it's a snack, it's a dessert, it's a sandwich, it's everything for me. The peanut butter and jelly is like a powerhouse.
Nice PB&J glass of milk.
Oh. Absolutely.
Come on. I mean, it's making me move my hands like a fucking Italian.
Now,
it's
if I can keep the grilled cheese and just get rid of, if I could just have peanut butter sandwiches. Does it have to be the
No, you said you could have. You said you could do.
But so it's like taking off the jelly doesn't make it a different sandwich. You know what I mean? It's
no, like, you said you could do like peanut butter and fluff. You could do peanut butter
and then I get to keep the
honey.
Grilled cheese.
Yeah.
Then in that case,
if I heard it right,
I thought he was saying that like variations.
No, I think variations would count with the peanut butter and jelly.
So oh, yeah, right, oh, okay. So you'd be gone. Yeah, okay, I mean, yeah.
Keeping the peanut butter.
You lose a fluff and utter sangy banky. Come on, the fucking. We were out last night with a couple of the fellas. Everyone's in town for the dozen. So went out with, I think, basically all of Barstool Chicago last night. I just happened to be scrolling Instagram while we were there and stumbled upon the snake draft. And Eddie wasn't there.
This is the sandwich draft. It's all over the map.
I mean, Eddie taking a grilled cheese round one.
Crazy.
That's too much. Carl got very defensive. Carl's like, look, I win a lot of snake drafts. That's a good pick. I said, I don't think so.
Yeah, no, it's not. I mean,
the PB&J went round two. Eddie also got that, which is a round two steal, if you ask
me.
But I don't think a grilled cheese is a round one
sandwich.
No,
and I saw, like, I think cheesesteaks went, like, third round or
something. Oh, come on.
Yeah, it was crazy. And then just things like, I think cheeseburger was included. I don't think that's a sandwich. There was no chicken cutlet sandwich anywhere to be found. It was.
I think a chicken cutlet sandwich is a very New York thing.
It's a delicious.
It's good.
Yeah.
I think it's just like, I mean, we had chicken sandwiches, but we just never called them chicken cutlet sandwiches. Like in Massachusetts.
Either way, there was no chicken sandwich, so that's a problem.
No chicken sandwich. Hang on a second, fellas.
Yeah.
What are we fucking doing?
While you look that up,
here.
I'm going to tell you about Revitalyte. They're sponsoring our final voicemail of the day. Right now, there's Revitalyte Black Label. Barstool has its own Revitalyte flavor now. And listen, we're no dummies. We know when you get in the game of drinks, when you're talking about hydrating drinks or energy drinks, you got to go with the blue. The blue is the best. And so we made the Revitalyte Black Label with the blueberry. And so that blue Revitalyte is the best one in the game. You drink the Revitalyte before you drink, while you drink, with your drinks, during your drinks, after your drinks, the next morning, and it helps you fight that hangover. It helps you stay hydrated and helps you get all those electrolytes. They're taking things to the next level with that black label that's made specifically for maximum recovery, and it's the perfect complement for your night when things get a little rowdy. So you can make it as a mixer. You can use it as how about this? Use it as a mixer. Use it as an elixir.
Ooh,
bam!
Yeah.
That's another good one. So go get the Revitalyte Black Label online at the Barstool Store and tweet at us and tag @drinkrevitalyte in your morning when you're posting your stories. So that's Revitalyte Black Label, available at the Barstool Sports Store right now. Before we do our last voicemail, what did you find? Did you see what I'm talking about? No chicken sandwich?
Yeah, but there is
some variations.
There's no chicken sandwich, but they do have a Nashville hot chicken, which went second round a little early, if you ask me. They got a chicken parm, which went third round, and they got a buffalo chicken, which went fourth round a little late, if you ask me.
Crazy. We need to clean that one up.
Yeah.
All right, what do we got? Last voicemail.
Hey, KFC, Feits, Nick, Jackie, everyone else back there. So I was listening to the Disney Adults podcast, and I'm from Florida, and it got me thinking about how many Disney Adults we have down here. And something really weird that they do is they like to keep all of their old parking stickers as a collection on the back of their car, and it's super just cringy. And it got me thinking, I was wondering, what is the cringiest bumper sticker you guys have ever seen on a car? Besides the stick people and the classic stuff like that, what is the worst bumper sticker you guys have ever sold? Steve.
Oh, stick people. Oh, the worst ones.
I can't think of a bumper. Does a t-shirt on a motorcycle guy count as a bumper sticker? Do you see those ones, if you can read this, the bitch fell off?
Yeah.
That's pretty bad. It's a pretty bad one.
What about, I don't like the my child goes to, like, blah, 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 middle school.
Oh,
my child's on the honor roll.
Honor roll, yeah.
Like, I want to burn your, I want to blow your car up.
Your parents put up, I have on the honor roll stickers, you are currently unemployed. I know it's a pandemic. Don't get down on yourself.
But still,
but
yeah.
Right now, you were, when your company was like, we got to let someone go, they were like, let's start
this
with
this guy first. He's on the honor roll at, you know, St. Joseph's.
Dude, if your parents put up that shit, you are like, you were destined to be mediocre.
Yeah.
You had no fucking chance.
We're clearly celebrating
the mediocrity.
Fault.
Yeah. And like, but you were destined. And that's not like, it's not like a participation trophy thing. That is just like, because it's not a participation trophy. It's actually an accomplishment. Getting on the honor roll,
sure.
You know, good for you.
Sure.
But
it doesn't need to be celebrated on a bumper sticker.
In heaven, so Jesus says a coexist bumper sticker. Those are lame as shit.
Yeah.
I mean, you could go through
anything too political. I'm not really a fan of.
Yeah. I was not raised in a political bumper sticker family, so I'm anti them.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm con. I'm con. I'm anti.
I'm having a stroke here.
Yeah. I could not think for a second there.
No.
That was
your brain
weird.
Shut down.
I just fucking froze up.
Don't have a brain. Don't have a cock. Don't have a heart. Played in perfectly. I think we can all agree though. Honor roll, political, religious. Those are the three.
There was one time I saw one that said, I hate fat chicks. And I was like, why would you have that as a bumper? And also, like, that's so offensive.
Kind of like that.
I saw one the other day on Instagram, I think, that said, only gay cops pull me over.
That's good. Great. That's funny. That's funny. Only pussy cops. That's great.
That one probably works. Like, that legitimately probably works.
Yeah. Like, I can see some cops being like,
no, homo.
I'll let him speed, whatever. That's fucking good. Yeah, sometimes bumper cycles give you a check.
Yeah.
All right, that's it for us. Make sure you go subscribe to our YouTube.
Baby on board.
Baby on
board. Well, I learned.
Baby on board is like, you know, please don't, like, you know, please don't drive recklessly around me, I guess. But it's like, you shouldn't be doing that anyway.
I actually learned, I take back the baby,
like,
on board.
EMTs to know or something?
It's for people to know if there's a car accident. So I used to think, like, oh, okay, I'll drive good now.
Right. That makes sense.
It is.
If anything goes wrong.
Yeah. Like, okay. Look for the baby that got ejected.
Okay, we're done here.
Subscribe to the YouTube, rate the podcast 5 stars, or your grandma's gonna die tomorrow.
What are you doing, Vince?
Oh, just watching a little KFC Radio on YouTube.
Are you subscribed to our channel?
Nah, it's not my thing. I don't.
So you're watching the videos, but you're not subscribed?
Yeah, I love you guys.
But not enough to subscribe.
I don't know where the button is. It's. Come on.
Do what you do. Fucking subscribe!
Kevin, hammer.
You fucking subscribe.
What happens to your fucking laptop?
This will be
you, your people, who don't subscribe! Ground and pound.
Fucking subscribe.
I need a new laptop!